This video demonstrates how to use Advanced Hunting to find URL clicks that download files. You use Advanced Hunting to combine, in new ways, the massive amounts of data that Microsoft 365 Defender logs to discover and understand threats to your enterprise. It uses Kusto Query Language, or KQL, to query all this data. In this video, I assume you have at least an intermediate understanding of KQL. If not, please have a look at our tutorial before continuing here. To demonstrate the power of Advanced Hunting, I'm going to build a query from scratch that combines three tables to find URL clicks resulting in file downloads. Those are the device events, device file events, and URL click events tables. At a minimum, I hope this example inspires you to combine, in new ways, tables from different domains. I'll start by looking for instances of the browser opening a URL. This query is uncomplicated. It simply returns all device events where the browser was launched to open a URL. The project operator is outputting the columns I care most about, like device, URL, and information about the initiating process. The next table I need is device file events. Here, I'm interested in files where the origin URL is not empty, meaning that it originated from the interwebs. Like before, I'll project the columns I care about most. I'd also like to include warnings from Smart Screen. I'll find that in the device events table, filtering for the action type Smart Screen URL Warning. The results include a JSON string called additional fields, which contains some useful information. So, I'll use the toDynamic function to expand that JSON, and then use the toString function to convert the experience value from dynamic back to a string. There's one thing missing still, and that's URL clicks. To get that information, I'll query the URL click events table. The URL chain column might contain multiple URLs in a single row if the initial URL redirected the user. So, I'll use the mvexpand operator to create an individual row for each URL in it, converting the URL to a string along the way. These four queries provide all the information I need when hunting for linked downloads. But if I were to start joining them as is, things are going to get very complicated very fast. Untenable, even. So, to keep the query that I'm trying to build simple, I'm going to assign the results of each query to the variables: browser navigation, downloaded files, Smart Screen URL warnings, and clicked URLs. Don't forget the required semicolons at the end of each let operator. Then I'll join them together in a meaningful way, starting with the browser navigation variable first, joining that with the downloaded files variable using the device ID and remote URL columns as keys. The results show any file downloaded by the browser. Because I didn't specify a join flavor, Advanced Hunting will use the default inner unique and deduplicate the browser navigation table by the device ID and remote URL columns in the process. Makes sense because I only need to see a URL once for each device. Moving on, I'll join the current results to the Smart Screen URL warnings variable on the same keys. I'm using the left outer join flavor here, so I'll get all my current results with any matching Smart Screen warnings added to them. Then, I'll continue by joining my results to the clicked URLs variable, using the remote URL column as the key. The value I'm after here is the network message ID. If there's a value in this variable, I know that the URL was found in an email and clicked. The last thing to do is to project the columns I might find useful. These obviously include the timestamp, file name, and remote URL. They also include the Smart Screen warning, whether the URL was clicked in an email, and the network message ID of that email, and information about the file and the process that initiated the download. Select Run Query to finally see the results of our effort. The result set includes a row for each time the browser was launched to open a URL and it downloaded a file as a result. We have additional information in the results, including any Smart Screen warnings and whether the link was clicked in an email. The query is pretty good so far, but it's common for attackers to chain together URL redirections to obfuscate its source. In other words, they email a link to a page that contains a link to a bad file. In this case, it's possible that the Smart Screen warning may have come from a referral. We'll handle that scenario by combining the previous query with a similar one that joins results by using the referred URL in combination with the remote URL. Now we have most of our bases covered, and we can hunt for URL clicks that resulted in a file downloaded or to pages containing links that resulted in a file downloaded. Advanced Hunting gives you incredible power to hunt across the wealth of data that Microsoft 365 Defender logs. To learn even more useful techniques for Advanced Hunting, see our documentation. Microsoft Security.